Hi, pleasure meeting you all. In today's session, I'm going to explain you about rake angle and its importance in endodontics. If you observe this diagram, this is the most irritating and difficult to understand at the level of graduation. This is nothing but design of a dental bar. These are the cutting edges and about rake angle. So let's start the session. So in today's session, I made a small attempt to make you clear in understanding about the rake angle, helical angle in a much better way, such that after watching this video, you will be enjoying in learning the rake angle and helical angle. Coming to the rake angle, why we should know about the rake angle? What is the importance of rake angle in the field of endodontics? Not only in the field of endodontics, but any rotary cutting instrument which has a blades, it has rake angle. So what is the importance of rake angle? You need to understand what is the use of positive rake angle, or what is the use of negative rake angle, what are the drawbacks of positive and negative rake angle. Actually, the positive rake angle, when I say a positive rake angle, it is directly proportional to the cutting action of the file. Suppose, if I say the burr has or a rotary file has a positive rake angle, it means it has more cutting efficiency. Whereas, if I say a burr or a rotary file, it has a negative rake angle, it means it has less cutting efficiency. It has more of scraping action. Whereas in positive rake angle, you will observe the actual cutting action. In case of a negative rake angle, you will have a more or less scraping action. Just you will scrape the dentine surface, right? You don't have a better cutting efficiency as compared to positive rake angle. So let's get into the topic now. Imagine myself as a rotary file. Or suppose, this is a long axis of a file, which is a mid-sagittal plane. This is considered as a long axis of a file. Imagine the ends of my fingers. These hands are my cutting edges, and the ends of my fingers are the blades. Right? For suppose, if I am rotating in a clockwise direction, these are my cutting edges and these are long axis of a file. Coming to the helical angle, the angle which is formed between the long axis of a file and the cutting edge. This angle is called as helical angle. For suppose, this is my cutting edge and this is the long axis of a file. The angle which is formed between the long axis of a file and the cutting edge is called helical angle. If you observe in this diagram, this is a root canal where a rotary file is inserted in the root canal. The rotary file is rotating in a clockwise direction. This will become your long axis of the file, right? So, the angle which is formed between the long axis of a file and these green color parts are your cutting edges, right? So the angle formed between the long axis of a file and this cutting edge, this angle is called helical angle. The angle formed between the long axis of the file and the cutting edge, this angle is called as helical angle. I repeat, if an angle is formed between the long axis of a file and this cutting edge, this angle is called as helical angle. Now let us see what is a rake angle and how does it differ from helical angle. Suppose this is a rotary file. If you take a cross section of a file and if you observe from the top, that means if you cut the file at this part and if you observe from the top view, suppose this is a rotary file and if you cut this file at this part and if you observe from the top view, this is the exact view. So if you zoom this diagram, this is the exact view. It has the cutting blades, see, these are the cutting blades and this is the rest of the file. These are the cutting edges, right? And this is actually the long axis of a file. If you observe this cross section, this is the radius of the file. That means the point which is running from the center of the file toward this end, this is called a radius of the file. The same way, if you take a cross section of a mine, right? Imagine this is a circle and if you take a cross section of a mine and this will become a diameter, right? and this is the radius. Half of the diameter is nothing but radius. If the angle is formed between the radius of the file, the angle is formed between the radius of the file and the cutting edge. This is my cutting edge. The angle is formed between the radius of the file and cutting edge. This angle is called as rake angle. If you see this diagram, this is the radius of the file and this is the cutting edge. This is the radius of the file and this is the cutting edge. The cutting edge has two faces. One is rake face and the clearance face. When the file is rotating in a clockwise direction, the face which first touches the cutting surface is called as a rake face. And the face which is behind the rake face is called a clearance face. A rake face or a leading edge or a cutting edge or a blade, all these have the same meaning. So I repeat, when a bow is rotating in a clockwise direction, the face of a blade which touches the cutting surface primarily or the first time, this is called as rake face. And the face which is present behind this rake face is called clearance face or a lagging face. So if you observe this diagram, this is your root canal wall, right? This is a radicular dentine. This green color part is the first face which touches this radicular dentine. So this is called as the rake face. And the face which is present behind this rake face is called as clearance face. Now coming to the rake angle, the angle which is formed between the radius of the file, this is nothing but the radius of the file, or it is a perpendicular down to the cutting surface. This is your cutting surface, and if you draw a perpendicular to the cutting surface, and the angle formed between these perpendicular or the radius of the file with the rake face, this is the rake face, this green color part is the rake face, so this angle is called a rake angle. I repeat, if the angle is formed between the radius of the file and with the cutting edge, this angle is called rake angle. Whereas, if the angle is formed between the long axis of a file and the cutting edge, this angle is called helical angle. If you see in this diagram, this is the long axis of the file, right? So the angle formed between the long axis of the file and this cutting edge, this angle is called helical angle. Whereas, the angle formed between the cutting edge and the radius of the file, this angle is called rake angle. So coming to the positive, negative and zero rake angle. For suppose this is the radius of the file and this is my cutting edge, which has two faces. One is the rake face, which is facing primarily towards the cutting edge, cutting surface, and the second face is the clearance face, which is the lagging face. First suppose, well, the burr is rotating in a clockwise direction. If the rake face is ahead, if the rake face is ahead of this radius of the file, this angle is called as a negative rake angle. I repeat, if the rake face is ahead or in front or before the radius of the file, this is called as negative rake angle. Whereas, if the rake face is behind or back of the radius of the file, this is the radius of the file and this is the rake face, it is behind or back of the radius of the file, this is called as a positive rake angle. If the rake face coincides exactly, if the rake face coincides exactly with the radius of the file, this is called a zero rake angle or a radial rake angle. I repeat, if the rake face is ahead of the radius of the file, this is called a negative rake angle. Whereas, if the rake face is behind or back of the radius of the file, this is called a positive rake angle. Whereas, if they are meeting end to end, this is called as zero or radial rake angle. So, if you observe this diagram, this is your cutting surface, whereas this is the radius of the file, right? Here, the rake face, which is the leading face, is ahead of the radius of the file, which is ahead, or it is in front of the radius of the file, or it is before the radius of the file. So this angle, the angle which is formed between the rake face and the radius of the file, is your rake angle. Since it is ahead of the radius of the file, it is called as negative rake angle. Whereas if you observe the second diagram, here the rake face is behind or back of radius of the file. This is the radius of the file and this is your cutting surface. The rake face is making an angle with this radius of the file, that is nothing but a rake angle. But the rake face is behind or back of the radius of the file. So this is called a positive rake angle. And coming to the third diagram, here the rake face coincides. The rake face coincides with the radius of the file. So this is called a zero rake angle or a radial rake angle. And one more thing, if a rotary file makes an obtuse angle, with the cutting surface, that is called a positive rake angle. If you see this diagram, here the rotary file or cutting edge is making an angle which is obtuse to the cutting surface. This is called a positive rake angle. Or suppose if, the cutting surface of a rotary file is making an acute angle which is less than 90 degrees, that is your negative rake angle. To make it simple, this is your 90 degrees, right? If the rotary file is making 90 degrees, or the cutting edge is making 90 degrees with this cutting surface, or a root canal wall or a radicular dentine, this is called as zero rake angle or radial rake angle. If it makes, or suppose the file is rotating in a clockwise direction, if it makes an obtuse angle, right, this is called a positive rake angle. Or suppose if it is make an acute angle, this is your acute angle less than 90, this angle is called acute angle, okay, this is called a negative rake angle. See, this is your perpendicular, right, this blue color is perpendicular, and this is an acute angle, right? So this is a negative rake angle. If it is make an obtuse angle like this, so this will become a positive rake angle and this is a zero rake angle. Hope it is clear. In this video, I am going to give a small demonstration about understanding what is a rake angle and helical angle in terms of an endodontic file. So I have made a small attempt to make you understand what exactly is helical angle and rake angle. For a practical demonstration, I have used this potato to explain the helical angle and rake angle in a better way. Consider this is your rotary file which is rotating in a clockwise direction inside the root canal, right? This is your root canal and this is rotating in a clockwise direction. And this will become your long axis of a file. So this is rotating in a clockwise direction and this is your long axis of a file. If you observe, these are your cutting edges, right? So the angle made between the long axis of a file with this cutting edge, this angle is called as helical angle. For suppose, if you take a cross section of this file and if you view from the top, so this is how it looks like. If I take a cross section, so this is the long axis of a file. So this is how it looks. So this is the long axis of a file. See, this is the long axis of a file. And these are my cutting edges. So these are my cutting edges. So when the file is rotating in a clockwise direction, if you observe this cutting edge, this cutting edge has two faces. One is a rake face, other is clearance face. The face which touches the surface first is called as rake face, and the face which touches later, the face which is behind the rake face, is called as clearance face. For suppose this is rotating like this, the face which touches first, so this is the face which touches while it is rotating, See, while it is rotating like this, this is a face which touches your dentin wall or a root canal dentin or a radicular dentin. So this face is called your rake face. And the face which is present back of it is called a clearance face. The area between these two faces is called land area. Now let us see what is rake angle. So if you see this picture, this will be your radius of the file, or this will be a perpendicular to this cutting surface. For suppose this is the cutting surface, this will be a perpendicular to cutting surface. Now if it is rotating in this direction, this will be your rake face and this will be your clearance face. This will be your rake face and this will be your clearance face, right? The angle which is made between this rake face and this radius of the file, this angle is called rake angle. I repeat, the angle made between the rake face and the radius of the file, this angle, the angle which is formed between this rake face, the angle which is formed between the radius of the file and the rake face, this angle is called rake angle. Whereas the angle made between the long axis of the file and this cutting edge, this angle is called helical angle. Now coming to the positive, negative and zero rake angle. There are three types of rake angles. One is a positive, negative and zero rake angle. If you see this diagram, when the file is rotating in a clockwise direction, the face, the rake face is ahead of the radius of the file. That means the rake face is ahead to this radius. That means it is in front of the radius, or it is before the radius of the file. So this type of angle is your negative rake angle. If you observe in this picture, the rake face, which is the primary cutting surface, is behind the radius of the file. So this is called as a positive rake angle. For suppose if this radius of the file coincides with the rake face. So you can see in this diagram, when the file is rotating, the radius of the file is exactly coinciding the rake face. This is called a zero rake angle. I repeat, when the file is rotating in a clockwise direction, in the first picture, the radius of the file is coinciding exactly with the rake face. This is called zero rake angle. If you observe the second diagram, while the file is rotating in a clockwise direction, if you observe this part, here the rake face is ahead of the radius of the file. So this is called as a negative rake angle. And coming to the third part, the file is rotating in this direction, in a clockwise direction. The radius of the file is ahead, or the rake face is behind the radius of the file. So this angle is called positive rake angle. Hope this small demonstration helps you in understanding what is exactly rake angle and helical angle, and what is positive rake angle, negative angle and zero rake angle. Coming to the examples of positive and negative rake angle, for a positive rake angle, the best example is H5 and your second generation rotary instruments, which include a Protaper Gold, Protaper Universal, Hero Shakos and K35s. These have active cutting edges. When I say a positive rake angle, the positive rake angle is directly proportional to the cutting efficiency of the file. If you increase the positive rake angle, your cutting efficiency of the file will increase. But the positive rake angle has two disadvantages. One is, due to positive rake angle, the bulk of the burr blade will be reduced. I repeat, due to positive rake angle, the bulk of the burr blade is reduced. As a result, while the burr is cutting, it has more chances of fracture. Since it has more cutting efficiency, since it has a positive rake angle, which leads to reduction in the bulkiness of the bubblehead, it has more chances of fracture. The second point, since it has active cutting, it cuts a larger portion of a dentin. It's called a dentin chips. So a large portion of dentin chips are generated, which clogs the fluid surface, or a chip space. This will become a drawback, right? So in a brief, positive rake angle is directly proportional to the cutting efficiency. When the cutting efficiency increases, the disadvantage of a positive rake angle is excessive cutting leads to digging of the file into radicular dentin. For suppose excessive cutting leads to digging of the file into the radicular dentin and finally leads into fracture of the file. While coming to the negative rake angle, has more or less scraping action. It doesn't have actual cutting action. It is more of scraping action. Since it is having scraping action, it needs more energy to scrape the dentin. So more heat is generated. Since there is no actual cutting, there is only scraping action, these instruments are less prone to fracture. So compared to the positive rake angle, negative rake angle have an advantage of less chances of fracture. The disadvantage is scraping action. You don't have an actual cutting action, right? The best examples of negative rake angle are K5 and the first generation rotary instruments, which includes Hero 642, Quantec, Lightspeed files, Profiles, and these are the files. So based on this information on positive and negative rake angle, if you observe the H file, it has highest cutting efficiency when compared to the K file. Even though the K file are more frequently or mostly used in root canal when compared to H file. Do you know what may be the reason? The reason is, since the H file has a positive rake angle, it has more cutting efficiency, right? But it has more chances of fracture. Whereas in K file, which has a negative rake angle, it has less chances of fracture. It has more of scraping action. So if you are shaping with the K file, it takes more time. And if you are shaping with the H file, it takes less time. But the drawback is the fracture rate is more in case of a H file, whereas less in case of a K file. So this is the reason why you use K file even though you have a better efficiency file like H file. Imagine this is your cutting surface. For example, this is your root canal dentin or a radicular dentin. And this is your rotary file. This is your cutting edge, which has two faces, which is the rake face and this is the clearance face. And this is your actual cutting edge. If the rake face is perpendicular to the cutting surface, this is your zero rake angle. For suppose, if the rake face is making an obtuse angle, this is your obtuse angle, this is your 90, this is your less than 90 acute, and this is more than 90 obtuse. So this is your 90, and if it is make an obtuse angle with the cutting surface, if this rotary file is making an obtuse angle, which is more than 90 with the cutting surface, this is called as positive rake angle. What is the action in positive rake angle? See, you can see the actual cutting action. See, this is the actual cutting action. See, this is the cutting action. This is the cutting action. So you observe actual cutting action in case of a positive rake angle. But whereas in case of a negative rake angle, where it is an acute angle, where it makes an acute angle, where the rotary file makes an acute angle with the cutting surface, you can see this is a scraping action. See, it's like a scraping action. There is no actual cutting. And if you observe the obtuse angle, this is the actual cutting, which is a positive rake angle. And if you observe the negative rake angle, which is an acute angle, this is a more of scraping action. I repeat,
This is your zero rake angle, which is 90 degrees. The file is making 90 degrees with the cutting surface. And if it is, the file is making obtuse angle, which is more than 90 degrees, there you have the actual cutting action. And if it is make an acute angle, which is less than 90 degrees, there you see a scraping action.
The angle which is formed between the rake face and a clearance face, this angle is called as edge angle. This angle is called as edge angle. So the angle which is between the clearance face and the rake face, this angle is called as edge angle. What is the significance of this edge angle? It provides strength to the burr. For a carbide burr, the edge angle is more or less equal to 90 degrees. Which are a brittle burrs, which are wear resistant, the edge angle is more or less or greater than or equal to 90 degrees. It provides strength to the burr. If you observe this diagram, this is your rake face and this is the radius of a burr. This is the radius of a burr and this is your rake face or a leading face. And this is your clearance face or lagging face. The angle which is present between the rake face and the clearance face, this is called edge angle. And coming to the last point, clearance angle. What is clearance angle? The angle which is formed between the clearance face or the lagging face to the cutting surface, that is called a clearance face. See, this is a cutting surface. The angle which is formed between the angle which is formed by the clearance face with the cutting surface, this is called a clearance angle. And coming to the importance of clearance angle, why the clearance angle is needed in a burr? The first importance of clearance angle is it provides space for the collection of debris, right? The second thing, it reduces the friction between the instrument and the cutting surface. Third point, it prevents excessive digging of file into the cutting surface. For suppose, if the clearance angle is reduced, this clearance angle is reduced, the face will come very close to this cutting surface. Then what are the consequences? As a result of reduction in this clearance angle, the space which is required for the collection of debris is reduced. The second point, there will be a generation of friction between this blade and the cutting edge. The third point, due to reduction in the clearance angle, there is excessive digging of a dentin. There is excessive digging of a cutting surface. Since the clearance angle has reduced, it has more chances for excessive digging of a dentin. So to conclude, if the angle is formed between the long axis of a file and the cutting edge, this angle is called as helical angle, whereas if the angle is formed between the radius of the file and the cutting edge, this angle is called rake angle. Coming to the positive, negative and zero rake angle, if the rake face is ahead of the, this is your negative rake angle. If the rake face coincides with the radius of the file, this is called a zero rake angle. If the rake face is behind or back of the radius of the file, this is called a positive rake angle. Or in other words, if it is make a 90 degrees with the surface, cutting surface, this is called a zero rake angle. If it is make an acute angle, this is your negative rake angle. Whereas if it makes an obtuse angle, it is called a positive rake angle. And positive rake angle is directly proportional to the cutting efficiency. If you have a positive rake angle, you have more cutting efficiency. In the same way, you have more chances to fracture. Whereas in case of a negative rake angle, you have more of scraping action rather than cutting action. There are less chances of fracture. And edge angle is the angle between the rake face and the clearance face. The edge angle gives the strength to the burr, whereas the clearance angle is the angle between the lagging face or the clearance face with the cutting surface. This clearance face provides space for the debris collection, reduces the friction and prevents excessive digging of the file into the dentin. Please let me know your valuable feedbacks in the comment section below, such that they will give a positive energy for me to work more efficiently to give a good videos. Hope you enjoy the session. Thank you.